The traveling salesman problem falls into a special class of problems called NP-hard. NP-hard problems don't have a known algorithm that can solve them in polynomial time. As I mentioned during the discussion of the knapsack problem, polynomial time algorithms have a runtime where n has a constant exponent, like n squared, and we want algorithms that can solve problems in polynomial time, or they're often too slow to be useful. The knapsack problem is actually also an NP-hard problem. The solution we looked at was in pseudo-polynomial time, and no true polynomial time solution is known. Since the problem is so difficult, there are two classes of algorithms considered solutions. The first are exact algorithms, which don't happen in polynomial time, but will get us the correct answer. The second are approximation algorithms, which don't always find the exact optimal solution, but generally find a near optimal solution. They tend to run in a more reasonable amount of time, and several are even polynomial time. The brute force solution to TSP has the same philosophy as the one for knapsack. Find every possible combination and pick the best one. But it takes significantly longer. It's in factorial time, so n multiplied by every integer between it and 1. There are also dynamic programming solutions for TSP. The most famous one is the Held-Karp algorithm. However, even the dynamic programming solutions are slow. The runtime for this particular solution is in exponential time. Even though the approximation algorithms don't find the exact optimal path, there is a lot of active research into them for TSP. One of the most famous, called Christofides algorithm, works by turning a graph into a tree, where the starting node is the root, creating and traversing through it in a particularly intelligent way. The algorithm guarantees that the path it produces will be at most 50% longer than the shortest route. There have been some slight improvements on this for specific cases of TSP, but generally it's considered to be the best there is. TSP is an interesting case study for this type of difficult problem, particularly since it has so many applications and is so widely studied. While you likely won't get asked about it directly in an interview, it's good to know that problems like this exist and that it is possible to get an interview problem with no efficient solution. You don't need to worry too much about the exact meaning of NP-hard or similar classes, but it's good to remember that even the brightest minds can't solve every problem efficiently.